wait a little bit. And then I see that it's recording. So this is one of my best invincible weapons. This is Zach Bowes. He's going to be here when I predict my greatness. And this is Samantha, his girlfriend, and she's super hot.
Thanks.
I know that you can see that. Everybody thinks she's hot. So, Zach, I want you to describe to Samantha my business model that I told you about. I don't know when because I've lost track of time.
It was only 2 days ago. And
this is completely unrehearsed.
You stood basically where you're standing now, or sat where you're sitting. And what you said was, all I have the energy to do is write and tell my story. And it takes everything out of me. It takes everything that I have. And so in order to keep on living, because you have this debt that's piling up, you need to figure out a way to make a living off of that, since you don't have the energy to do anything else. And so basically what you told me was, you're gonna put it out there and people can read it and experience it. And if they like it, they should pass it on and tell somebody else about it. And if they love it, they should read more. And if it changed their life, they should give you money and they should help you out.
And when I said that to you, did you think that I had the power to write in such a way that could change someone's life?
Yeah, man.
Why? I've written 2 chapters and put it on the internet.
Well, mainly because I'm biased. And because you've always been the best friend that anybody could ever ask for. So that's why I'm biased. And you've already changed my life. So if you change my life, I feel like you have the ability to change other people's.
But I haven't even released the best chapter that I'll ever write, which is chapter 3. The first 2 are shit, dude. That's how good a writer I am right now. Have you even read them? Honestly.
I read the first chapter.
Awesome.
And you know me. I'm going to get around to chapter 2.
Yep. We were trying to pull it up on my phone on the way here, but it's very tiny, so.
I don't care when my book gets read. I don't care if you're a 32-year-old man dying of who knows what in his apartment when you read it, but when you do, it'll be good. There's no rush, man. You can go on vacation. Don't let it stress you out. So I now have evidence, and I haven't even released chapter 3, the best chapter that I will ever write. So I want you to film me, okay?
Okay.
And it's going to be a film of a film, okay? This is what technology has made possible. Technology in the minds of man and the drugs that are ripping me apart made this possible. This wouldn't exist without all of it, the good and the bad and the evil. It's going to be one of the life lessons you guys don't understand yet because chapter 3 hasn't dropped, but... So I've been... The mysterious Galadriel are the only ones who have seen any chapters past chapter 2 as of right now. Jordan's my boy, and I trust him artistically more than I've trusted anyone in my entire life, so that's why I send him, because when I'm in these psychotic messes, I can trust him. If he says that it's good, then I believe it. If anyone else says that it's good, I would doubt it. So, I just sent this to Jordan. And the question is, can I write well enough to change someone's life? Because that's what it's going to take to make a living as an author, okay? Dude, this is epic fucking shit. Check it out. There's a girl who just put this on Facebook. My friend Janelle is going through similar things to me that I am today. She wrote this and posted it to Facebook. A scream awoke me. A scuffle on the roof followed. I awoke Glenn. Another loud series of thumps from above. Pants, on, lights, on, airsoft pellet gun with the orange painted over the tip, in hand. Glenn opens the back door. My ear is pressed. See, she did a tense error. I've been having tense errors, and I thought it was because I'm insane and time is blending, but writers have tense errors. It's something we have to work through. If you're a writer, you have to work through tense errors, and they're really hard to find, especially through tears and prednisone, but you can find them. If I can find them, you can find them. Glenn opens the back door. My ear is pressed up to the bedroom window curtains. I am holding my breath. Mystery noise in the darkness then slides down the side of the house in a ruckus. Just on the other side of the pane of glass I am leaning on. It rustles in the dried leaves below. I call 911. A half dozen cops arrive within 2 minutes. Guns drawn, they search our roof and yard. Neighbors who called in the attempted burglary in December come out back to report seeing a wicked raccoon the size of a small bear. Embarrassment rises as fast as the relief did. Police are thanked. They warn us to keep Otis inside for the night because these things are supposedly quite vicious. Hopes of the first good night's sleep this weekend are wrecked. Going back to sleep before the ungodly 2 a.m. stomach pain strikes again. Allergist appointment tomorrow. Zzz. Before I recorded this video, we're back to Nathan. Before, what the hell am I talking about?
Like you, she sent.
She put this on Facebook before I recorded this video. Okay. Then I recorded this video. Videos within videos. Hello, Invincible Weapons. It is I, your humble protagonist. And I've been cracked out on prednisone all night trying to figure out how to make iMovie work. This is about my billionth attempt, so I'm pretty good at it by now. Point of this message is a status update on the release of Chapter 3. Remember, I'm not letting it go until I've gotten 100 thingies, so let's check it out. We have 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60, 65, 70, 71, 72 thingies as of 5:15 a.m. on Thursday, June 6th, I think. We've also added two new invincible weapon upgrades, number 13 and 14. One of them used to live in this building. His name is Glenn. He was awesome. Janelle, I'm gonna be contacting you soon. I'm weak. Pause. I just said Glenn and Janelle in a psychic frenzy or whatever. Glenn is one of the new invincible weapon upgrades, and Janelle is an old invincible weapon upgrade. Glenn is actually an old invincible weapon. He just got upgraded because we weren't friends on Facebook, but he's always been an invincible weapon for me. Great guy. I freaking love every second I've spent with him, and we've spent way far too few of them together. But Janelle and Glenn are boyfriend and girlfriend, okay? And they met because Janelle, I don't even remember how we connected, and my brain is too frazzled right now. But at the time when I was working for Villager Publishing, it's actually gonna be Chapter 5 is Villager Publishing, over in Grand Junction, I abandoned my apartment for, my apartment to go to work in Grand Junction, which leads to the story of why I didn't talk to my mom for 2 years. Because the story is ultimately the tale of a redemption between a mother and a son, and I'm doing that on purpose because middle-aged women buy the most books. I'm showing you my hand. I haven't released Chapter 3 yet, so you guys don't know what that means, but I'm showing you my hand. I do not have a terrifying presence. There's nothing but honesty and hope in me now, because this sickness has taken everything else. So I went over the mountains, and I had an empty apartment, and Janelle needed an apartment. So I let her stay here. And that's how they met. And right now, she's going to be able to avoid this. She's going to be able to avoid this because of what I wrote. And I haven't even released chapter 3. And she's in love. Because of my pain.
To spend my energy very wisely, but I'm going to be contacting you soon because I think I have some help for you. I just got some help tonight that blew my mind, and it almost got me to sleep, which doesn't sound like much, but my insides feel whole instead of jittery. So Janelle, I'm thinking of you, I'm coming for you, I really want to call you, but I have to spend my energy very, very selectively. And right now, the important part for me is to tell the story. It's so important for me to tell the story. Not only that, I think that we're on the edge of a new kind of literary art form, the multimedia book, if you will. I'm going to be assembling a website in the near future. It's going to be awesome. Not only that, Facebook is already allowing us to experience the creation of this book as it's happening, okay? That's amazing. So I'm going to give foreshadowing within the book, outside of the book, okay? On my wrists are proof that I was in the ER last night. It's a hilarious story. It's called The Hilarious AIDS Test, okay? I haven't written it yet, but it's gonna be a great chapter. You guys are going to love it. Nothing serious, but I was wandering around last night at 2:30 in the morning looking for my car. Those of you who know me know that even when I'm fully rested, I can never find my car. So you can imagine what I went through.
Me looking for my car on these drugs ended in an AIDS in an AIDS test, you fucking Kugelman Mad Hatter fool.
Exactly what I'm talking about because it's the first of the month. Anyways, it's a hilarious AIDS test. I'm HIV free, negative. I don't have AIDS, so that's good. Anyways, that's the status update. I'll be releasing chapter 3 as soon as we get 28 more thingies. Thanks to every one of you. I truly mean this. I am alive because of you.
All right, Dark Lord Sauron, motherfucker. Mad Hatter, trying to kill me, who I also love, because you've given me the most beautiful ending to this book. It's going to sprawl on for years because I need a job for years. I'm going to be very selfish and all of you are going to be my weapons for a long time. But I promise you this, that I will use this weapon and I'm not going to blow up cities. I'm going to use it to change lives. Right now there are hurting people out there. We got to finish the story. Sorry. This is how you can write real fast, guys. Get super sick with something no one can diagnose and then whack yourself out on prednisone.
Truth.
Okay. Where are we, man? I need help.
So.
I'm here.
Yep.
Holy fuck, girl. We are the same person right now. I just posted my first YouTube video to Facebook, and it talks about you. I knew something was wrong stomach-wise, but I didn't realize the severity until right now. You just became my first priority, taking precedence over the book and anything else. I'm going to call my mom as soon as I'm able to speak. I take my meds in the morning and they make me they make it so all I can do is cry. I don't mess up when I'm on prednisone, man. I just mess up when I'm reading on prednisone. So all I can do is cry until around noon. And I'll ask her if she has any white witches in her Jesus coven over in San Francisco. Last night, one of her fellow practitioners of the healing arts came to my apartment and gave me so much healing it was unbelievable. So step one, find out if there's a Jesus witch in San Francisco. If there is, we'll see if she can help. If not, we'll find a way to get you out here or one of the three blessed healers who are currently helping me out to San Francisco to help you. I'll be in touch as soon as possible. Hang in there, I'm coming for you. To which she replied, Nathan. And this made me feel good, thank you, because on the prednisone, I was like obsessing about you and I was just trying to get rest so that I could get up enough in me so that I could call my mom so that she could call you so we could get a Jesus switch out to you, but the fact that you told me real quick that you were okay kept off the psychotic outburst, the beginnings of which, or the aftermath of which has already been posted, and you guys aren't going to know about that until this book is over. Your writing alone is helping me. Yes, focus on that first. It is what got me to make several more appointments last night. Denial was a rough and painful phase, but you got me through it. Thanks, friends. Just get better, okay? So she's gonna be okay. And I've already recorded something, and I'm not gonna re-record it because it's perfect. And so in the comic books, what they do when they wanna go back in time is they release a zero issue, and it's basically a money grab, and that's exactly what I'm gonna use it for. I'm showing you my terrifying presence. I'm gonna, my rattled mind, probably in the next 3 seconds as I'm reading, is gonna come up with a way to capitalize on zero, selling this zero idea, and you guys are gonna buy it. And first I'm gonna get myself healthy, and I'm gonna buy myself a house. I love my bone's eye. Right now he's sitting outside because it rained last night. It was a beautiful rain last night. So I couldn't sleep, so I took him outside so he could be in the rain. And I see that he needs to come in because his leaves will scorch. Would you go get him, Samantha?
Yep.
Because I can't walk too good. I don't know if you guys can see how skinny I am. But someday I'm going to tell you about him. So I'm going to get a house, and they need a yard, because bonsai. Bonsai have to be outside, but that little guy's tough. And he's been growing in here, I don't know, I'm going to say for a million years in poetic time. And he's tough right now, he knows how to be tough, but I'm going to teach him how to be weak. And then I'm gonna teach him that middle place. I'm gonna teach you guys all about that too, and about balance, and when to be strong, and when to bend. It's Taoism. If you wanna get a head start, you can read The Tao Speaks, Class Starts When My Mind Heals, or maybe right now. This is the power of invincible weapons, guys. This is the power of love. Someday it'll all make sense, and it's gonna be a long time, because I need a job for a long time. You guys are going to have to keep me healthy for a long time. She hasn't even seen chapter 3. This is the greatest chapter that I will ever write. Nothing will ever compare to it, and no one will ever be able to convince me otherwise. This is a place where I've been strong. I've drawn the line, and I refuse to write anything better than chapter 3. She hasn't seen it yet. To which I said, Janelle, what you just told me is exactly why I am on the verge of turning this epic interactive web book into a thing that will make it so I won't have to go back to school for electrical engineering. I will be able to make a living changing lives with my words. I have already recorded the congratulations video for the 100 thingy challenge, and in it I describe how I am going to accomplish this. The fact that my two chapters have already gotten you over the hump is proof that my plan will work. Thank you so much for your courage and honesty. I am alive because of you. I am about to become the thing I have always dreamed of being, an artist who makes a living with his art, and I will do it while helping people in a meaningful way. Holy fuck. Keep this email. Because I'm crazy on meds, and we'll have to tell this story someday. I mean it. Keep it. This is literally the most valuable email, in real dollar terms, you have ever received. Do you need me to star in your next movie, Hollywood? I'll do that. As a way to make money so that I can keep writing books and keep changing lives. But you will never have the rights to this book. You will never so much as set foot near it. Fuck you, Hollywood. Other people wrote that shit, and you are not a better writer than Tolkien, and you ruined that miserable wretch of a movie. I hate you, Peter Jackson. This is the way that I used to think. It's true. at the exact same time, it's true that I love you, Peter Jackson, because nobody would know what the fuck I was talking about unless they'd seen Golem-ing on the screen, unless they'd seen him coming at you, little Golem. I'm Golem. I've been identifying with Golem. Not only do I have to deal with tense errors, I have to deal with typing we in the middle of the night as my eyes fill with tears. I have to remove we and I have to put I. That's how fractured I am. That's how broken I am. And the terrifying part is I did it to myself. Zach, what did I do? Where was I when you came over?
The other night?
No, right now.
Oh, you were in your bed.
Yeah.
Lying down.
Yeah.
Are you talking about what you've done for the last 30 years? Like eat really sugary cereals?
I've lost track of everything. Put it back on me. Here's the deal. I was laying in bed, listening to the Adam Carolla podcast, trying to sleep. I could give you a scientific number that would tell you exactly how long it's been since I've slept. We could calculate it to within a speck of an atom. We could do that. Because I've been keeping fevered notes. This is how you can be crazy and sane at the same time. This is how you can be sick and well at the same time. This is how you can bring life and death at the same time. This is how two things can be one. What I saw in that deprivation tank was both true and the result of the meds that the Mad Hatter, that wonderful man, gave me and sent me spiraling down into the rabbit hole. So I was laying there, right? I wasn't writing. Do you see any really long script that I've had time to memorize during my illness? So this is real, right? I was gonna say one of my fears is that people won't think it's real, but now my only fear is that this isn't recording and that we didn't get any of this.
You can double check. I think we're good.
I don't know. I'm a goddamn nut. I'm not sure that... it's very possible that I'm in an insane asylum right now, and my friends are very worried about me, and my mother, who loves me, is praying that witch doctor from Jesus. Okay, so...
This is real.
Alright, this is real. That takes a load off. That takes a lot of anxiety off. Keep this email, because I'm crazy on meds, and we'll have to tell this story someday. I mean it. Keep it. This is literally the most valuable email in real dollar terms you have ever received. Galadriel, I told you that I would make you immortal. I just did. But it's too late. You don't get any of the profits. I can't wait to see you, but I promise you that they will be used for good. I'm going to do my best to do good from now on. Zach, do I give bums money?
Nope.
No? So,
I noticed that the other day, though. I almost commented on it. I figured I'd let it lie.
Because we fight all the time. I'm very... Well, actually, everyone, right now, pause. Is this thing... Remember this thing. We started with paradox, okay? We started with paradox. I love teaching so much.
He's a good teacher.
I am a good teacher, and I'm really sorry... I can't remember your name. You're a teacher at Denver School of the Arts, and I think you're amazing. And I'm really sorry that I bailed on you, but when I was an electrical engineer, which was 8,000 bajillion years ago, I think, I'll leave you to make your own conversions. I abandoned you in the middle of a semester, and it was a dick move, but I had to because my classes were super hard, and I apologize for every time that I called you cunt, teacher whose name I can't remember because my brain is so frazzled, and someday I'll tell you that in person, and I'm going to come down and see you, Runcible, or whatever. Anyway, I love teaching, and I'd love to come back and work with you guys at DSA, maybe even before I'm wealthy. But I want to come in there as much as I can, but I want to teach painting and drawing. I want to teach kids that are passionate about the same things that I am. I'm wicked good in Photoshop, and that's making me better on Canvas. I don't know, maybe you guys could get a sick kid in there who can move his arms like Chuck Close, and I'll just work with him. And his paintings are going to sell for a lot of money, and he's going to be able to like cure himself or whatever. A long time ago, I just told Sarah Creek this story. Out on my deck, you're going to be a magic card, and I'm going to hire the best artist. I'm going to hire Edge Singh maybe to do the whole set, but he's going to paint all the pictures of people that I've been making stand by that door, and I've been taking pictures of them, and by all those people, this is where lines can blur in reality. All these people is to the White Witch didn't want me to take her picture because she wasn't done up. She's maybe a little vain, but that's okay. I forgive her. But I'm a prophet. I'm predicting the future. When you guys bring me that sickly little kid who can barely move his arms like Chuck Close, his paintings are going to sell for enough money that it'll be able to support him and his family for generations. I'm a prophet, Sarah. When I told you that, none of this had happened yet. I couldn't have possibly known that. I had a psychotic episode today where I imagined that I can't say it yet. Do I give bums money?
Not generally, no.
No? How much money do you think I gave that man for this paper?
A suggested donation is $2.
So you think I gave him $2?
I don't want to guess.
What's that?
I said I don't want to guess. How much did you give him? More than $2?
I don't want to show you my hand yet.
But you got his paper. So you must have given him something.
My muscles are beginning to grow. Technology and science coming together. Faith. Light. Healing. You guys have been watching for 1,000,000 years. This is it, guys. You're beautiful.
I'm worried about you.
Show me your hand.
I love you. Okay?
Wait, there's three of us. How long? Can't do it. Dude, I'm tired, man. Seriously, like that.
Should we turn it off?
I know everything. It hurts. I am everything. And it hurts. Sleep, perchance to
probably enough for now.